Hey guys, I'm Sybin and welcome back to the Aether Hub for more Magic the Gathering lore. Today we're continuing the story of Dominaria, but first let's quickly go over what happened in our last video. Last time we followed Joyra as she was gathering her new Weatherlight crew. A legendary ship like the Weatherlight needed a legendary crew, so Joyra was hell-bent on getting herself a Sisse and a Cabochon to be her new crew members. She eventually convinced both Shauna Sisse and Raph Cabochon to join her crew. Now, together with the angel Tiana, whose story we're about to get into, the vampire knight Arvad, and of course the planeswalker Ajani Goldmane, the Weatherlight is ready to fly the skies of Dominaria once more. However, today we're not going to continue that story. No, today's story actually takes us back as we explore the origins of Tiana, Weatherlight's angelic engineer. But before we jump into the next official chapter of Dominaria, why don't you be an angel to the channel and check out our Patreon page? As the channel most dedicated to the lore and story of MTG, the Aether Hub can only pump out as much content as we do through the help of the Vorthos army. We're currently working on fully animated character trailers right now, and those are only made possible through our fans. As a member of the Vorthos army, you of course get signed loot from me, along with some other exclusive goodies such as access to our Discord as well as polls deciding the topics of our next animated trailers, and sneak peeks into the behind-the-scenes work that goes into making those videos. All support of any size is greatly appreciated, and a link to the Hub's Patreon can be found in the description below. And with that, let's get back to the lore. Our story starts in the Cathedral of Serra, where Tiana has just been brought to life. We aren't given the exact details on how the Angels of Dominaria are created, but the leader of the Angels, Lyra Dawnbringer, explains to us that Tiana was created because the mortals of this world had prayed for her. Not for her specifically, but they had prayed for an angel who will protect the Great Machine, a device that seemingly carries water from a reservoir up the side of a plateau to a town. Judging by this, angels are born out of necessity. Whenever mortals have a great need for them, they can pray and an angel will be born, an angel to fulfill that specific purpose. Tiana isn't really happy with this. These are dark times. The Cabal is threatening the world, so when she came into being, she was sure that she was brought to life to do what angels do best, fight the forces of evil. So at first, her purpose had seemed a bit underwhelming, but it was her purpose nonetheless, and as an angel, it was her duty to fulfill it. Before leaving the domain of angels, Tiana had engaged in a brief conversation with another angel, Aphra. Aphra was glad that she finally came into being, but she couldn't help but notice that something seemed a little off. Tiana should have been created much, much earlier, and it usually doesn't take this long for an angel to come into being. The two concluded that it was probably due to the very specific purpose that she was set to fulfill. Tiana's attention shifted from Aphra to a portrait on the wall, a portrait of Gerard Cabochon. She studied the man, soaking in every detail, and wondered where he got his spear from, but before anyone could answer her, the Aven clerics arrived with her new armor and weapons. Due to her excitement, Tiana kinda forgot about her question. Tiana said her goodbyes to Aphra and flew to the town that hosted this great machine. However, she didn't go alone. Lyra Dawnbringer chose to escort Tiana to the machine just to make sure that everything was gonna be alright with her. Again, it doesn't take this long for an angel to be created, so this was a bit concerning, but surely everything was alright, right? Well, unfortunately, it actually wasn't. When the two finally made their way to the town, they had discovered that, to their shock, the Cabal had already attacked the Great Machine, and because there was no angel there to protect it, the Cabal managed to destroy it and the town. The people of the town were left with no way to transport water, and Tiana was left with no purpose. The angels did the best they could, helping the survivors and putting out fires, but obviously it was a very solemn day for Tiana, this guardian angel who now had nothing to guard. We pick up with Tiana investigating the remains of the Weatherlight, or better said, the partially restored Weatherlight. An unknown amount of time had passed since the destruction of the Great Machine, and Tiana had found a new purpose in life. She was given the role of the Restoration Overseer, a role given to her by Joyra, and it was her duty to make sure everything on the skyship ran smoothly. That was no problem for her, because she knew a lot about the Weatherlights, more than she probably should have known, which was both reassuring and frightening at the same time. She didn't know how she knew all this stuff, she didn't study mechanics or anything like that. She was an angel, and her knowledge came directly from Serra, but she couldn't recall any of this knowledge about the Weatherlight a couple days ago. Actually, she realized this all started when she brought the Powerstone back to life. Something changed within her that was granting her all this knowledge about the skyship, but how and why exactly this happened, she doesn't know. Later that night, Tiana was standing guard over the Weatherlight when one of the restoration crew brought urgent news to her attention. A man was spotted, a single man dressed in banalish knight armor, making his way towards them. Worried that this could be a Cabal agent, Tiana flew to meet this man, but instead of finding the Cabal, she found a vampire. The man introduced himself as Arvad and explained that he didn't come here looking for a fight. Tiana was doubtful because vampires weren't exactly known for their calm demeanor, but Arvad assured her that he was unlike other vampires. Instead of embracing this curse, he did his best to reject it, not allowing himself to drink the blood of others, though occasionally he would lose control and devour the blood of a Cabal agent or two. A man's gotta eat sometime, right? When asked what he was doing here, Arvad explained that he wasn't sure himself. Something had drawn him there, something he couldn't really explain. And all he really knew was that he had been drawn here ever since about 2 months ago. 2 months ago, exactly when the Power Stone was brought back to function by Tiana. For whatever reason, the stone was calling Arvad here, and Tiana's curiosity begged to answer why that was. She decided to test a theory. Perhaps the power of the Power Stone could cure him of vampirism. The two made their way towards the stone, and after touching it, Arvad becomes less pale and his fangs had shortened, but he was still very much a vampire. Theorizing that a prolonged exposure to the Power Stone might cure him, Tiana allowed Arvad to remain on the ship as the newest member of its crew. A few days have gone by, and the exposure to the Power Stone actually made Arvad able to remain in the sunlight, something that Dominarian vampires are incapable of doing. For the first time in a long time, Arvad was truly happy. There was a real chance that he might one day become human again. He had found a new purpose in life, and upon asking Tiana what her purpose was, he learned about her being born too late to fulfill a purpose, and now she was an angel with no mission. She was born to protect the great machine, but she was born too late. Arvad tried to be inspirational. The Weatherlights may not be the great machine, but it was a great machine. So maybe, just maybe, her true purpose had lied with the skyship. But Tiana was fairly certain that because she was an angel, her place was with the Church of Serra, not with Joyra on the Weatherlight. But, one day, a nearby explosion caught the crew's attention. At first, they thought that maybe a nearby volcano had erupted. But this was no volcano. It was a wild phoenix. The flaming bird seemed hellbent on burning down the Weatherlight, and Tiana couldn't let that happen. Without any hesitation, the angel drew her sword, engaging the phoenix in combat, and actually managed to slay the beast. Of course, she didn't do this on her own. Arvad was instrumental in destroying the phoenix before it could burn down the Weatherlight. Though Tiana played some great defense in the air, Arvad's skill with a bow and arrow gave Tiana the upper hand in actually killing the beast. When she struck it down, Tiana had realized that she had found her new purpose. For the first time since her birth, she felt like an actual guardian angel, the Weatherlight's guardian angel. And when Joyra returned, Tiana accepted her position on the skyship. This new purpose wasn't the one she was born to, but it was the one she wanted. And that, you guys, was the latest chapter, Chapter 4 of our storied return to Dominaria. It's great seeing the backstory of these new characters, these new heroes of the Weatherlight. But Tiana is much more than that. She's a weird key to the link between angels and Serra on Dominaria. What could this mysterious connection actually mean? And what type of magic keeps her presence here? Only time will tell, but it's sure as hell flavorful. Anyway, it's time for another giveaway here on the Hub. Last week's winner was announced via Twitter, so if you aren't following me yet at SibonLore, make sure you do to catch if you're the winner of this week's card. And what card is that? Well, Tiana herself, of course. But how can I give away a card to a set that hasn't released yet? I have my sources, guys. No, in reality, the winner will be picked sometime after the pre-release, so I'll probably have my hands on one by then. Regardless, you'll have yourself an early Tiana Ship's Caretaker. Just make sure you leave a comment on the video, subscribe, and of course, share it with your friends in order to enter. As always, guys, if you enjoyed the video, why don't you help the hub out by doing everything I just mentioned anyway, along with checking out our Patreon page. As always, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time here on the Aether Hub.